Hey friends, it's 9/9/2013 today. Thought I'd come out here and address a few things that are coming up here in less than, a little over 20 days. Headlines today reads, if you can see that, okay, and what it's saying here, healthy Hoosiers face huge premiums under Obamacare. That's what's coming up October 1st. An Indianapolis resident making $28,725 a year could get subsidized insurance for $193 a month from the new health care marketplace. Okay. It says here also, for example, with the Obamacare, a 60-year-old earning more than about $46,000 could pay a premium of $531 a month for the lowest cost plan. What this is saying is, with the Obamacare, if you presently have no good insurance for you, your spouse, and your dependents, your children, you will be paying a premium price for the insurance, and you will be demanded to do this, and you will be fined if you do not carry this insurance. There's going to be ifs and buts about it. You will have to do this. This amongst the other things that's in that package of the Obamacare. Yet everybody still believes this man is the right person to lead this country and has the moral fabric and judgment and logic to do his job. I'm finding a problem with it, guys. But, you know, you're going to get a real answer tomorrow evening. He's going to address the world and America, okay? He's going to tell you he is going to carry out this bombing, okay? That's what is programmed in this program for tomorrow evening. There's been a scuttlebutt on the net that the Pentagon released some information that within 72 hours, there will be a three-day campaign from ships to shore with missiles, and from air to ground with missiles, and a three-day campaign to bombard Syria. They've already got the places picked out. They've got everything picked out. The only thing they haven't, and apparently it doesn't much matter, is who the innocent are and how many are going to perish. But this is already set in motion. It's going to happen. World War III is about to unfold. So I suggest you just get your heart right with the Lord. And I know a lot of my friends out there have already prepped. Just be ready for this, okay? Because as soon as they start this campaign, those of the Arabic countries that will be in defiance to this and the rest of the world, which our understanding is Russia and China and some other countries, that the price of oil will go skyrocketing. The instability of our ability to purchase fuel and move and supply different areas with food is going to slowly, progressively make a definite change in our comfort life, okay? Do I know this for a fact? Yeah. Because we have come to a point in our world, because we're so fast and everything is so, actually the world ain't that big anymore, that when a threat is answered with a threat and there is no negotiation and violence is pushed to the point, then they're going to use every means they can to inflict pain upon the opponent. You know, we may push the button, we may go ahead, Obama and his group of wild people, insane people, will do this, and when they do that, we will be the one to receive the harvest of what these countries want to put upon us. You know, we'll be paying higher prices at the gas pump, higher prices at the food if we can get food. It's gonna be a complete reflection upon what's going on out here. I watched an old boy today trying to sort through what he's seeing in graphs and stuff of radiation versus the West Coast versus a part of the rest of the country. He has to remember that this radiation is real. And if you see in low doses of radiation on the coast right now, because the airstream is in the northern part of the hemisphere, up through Canada. Okay, and as long as that's being carried through the northern part, ask the Canadians. Get some readings from Canada, and then you'll understand where the Fukushima radiation is. Okay? But as soon as that airstream drops down, it will be back across the east, the west coast, and back through the central part of the United States. Okay? There's a little, I'm going to put his site down there. There's an old boy, I believe he's out of Missouri, and he does a pretty good job of doing the radiation thing. He said Sunday they were getting some super high readings from the rain that fell, okay? And he's not sure if it literally came from Fukushima or if it came from something that happened over in Illinois that was a fire, or if it came up out of Louisiana for what's going on down there. There's three variables there, but the radiation levels were like 108 times what it normally should be. Okay, so I'm gonna put his site down below in the description box, and you can search him and keep up with him because he gives some pretty accurate readings, and I've been watching him for a while. So we'll check him because the other readings we're not real sure about. And you have to understand, if the readings are low in certain areas, it could be because that airstream is high. Okay, the airstream is flowing through Canada and not dropping down into the Americas here. So that's how it will vary. You know, but there's still a possibility with wind and rain and whatnot could still carry that radiation to the southern part of the states. So with that said, without going on and on and on, to keep this short, I just wanted to bring to you that this is one thing that we know is going to happen. And without any improbability, unquestionability, within the power of our insane president, Obama, he's going to go ahead and start this conflict, okay? And I think that's with or without Congress or anybody else's permission. I know myself, I got an email and a little document, and I said hell no on it. You know, more or less, I said no, I don't want him to start this war and mailed it back to the guy, you know, but I'm sure others have gotten that. But they don't care anymore. It doesn't matter what we think, and it hasn't for a long time. So that's how things are right now. I'm going to try and catch the moon and Venus again, and maybe catch Saturn that's above it, supposedly above it. I watched a video this morning, actually late last night, but this morning I watched it again. There's an old boy sent me. In Australia, it was awful odd that the moon was rocked with the tips pointing north and the rocker pointing south, and Venus was below it. Yet in my video, it's turned so it's pointing south and the rocker's pointing north, and Venus is sitting there off to the north end of it. In other words, it's sitting upright, but it seems odd. The same moon, the same Venus, in a different part of the world, appears differently on camera. And then I've got another old boy. I tried to put his video up about the pole shift, and because he had some news on it or something, I couldn't do it. They put a third strike or put a copyright immediately, and I pulled it down. But what he's saying is because the moon and what is tracking and how Venus is tracking with it, right now, it's at the tracking position. It shouldn't be in until December. So it's way ahead of the game. It's 40 degrees out of whack. And if it progresses any further because of the whole thing, I'll link that link down below and you can watch it. It's quite interesting. It just kind of broke my heart. I couldn't mirror that one for you, but he's got some good data, that old boy out of Australia. And he explains this a lot more detail with graphics and stuff than I can. But anyway, God bless you. Hug the kids. Hug the wife. The old Marine Vaughn on September 9th, 9/9/2013. The Lord loves you. Jesus loves you more than I can. Jesus is the only way to heaven. So God bless you. Remember that, friends. Keep him in your heart and prepare yourself. And get your prayers ready, because we're going to have to pray for this activity going on here real soon. And we need to pray about this thing, how it's going to put everybody in the poorhouse. If you don't understand it, because I'm telling you right now, as soon as this comes into effect, the people that are carrying you on insurance, companies are going to try to swindle them way out of that situation and make you take it upon yourself. That's how it's going to unfold. So, God bless you. Have a good day. You know, hope is still there that we'll be taken out of here and not have to deal with it anymore. You know, we'll come back to a better earth of the way the Lord intended it. God bless you, friends. Have a good day. Bye-bye. We love you. We'll take a look at the sky here real quick. And I thank all of you that watch my videos and the comments. I read them all. I don't get a chance to reply to all of them, but I appreciate them, friends. And those that send me PM with the videos and stuff, I try to keep up with it. But that's our sky for today, and we'll try to catch that tonight, this evening. So God bless you. Have a good day. Bye-bye.